You are short on time, but want to be up to date with what is happening in AI world. Next is the most prominent announcements and changes from May 2023. Reference links below for more information. Plenty to cover, so let's begin. Let's start with a section which initially I wanted to call When You Have a Lot of Money, but later I decided to rename it to The Big Fish. So Google just had their annual I/O conference, which by now should have been renamed into Google Annual AI Conference, and they announced a lot of different things. Palm 2 is the latest large language model released by Google, supports more than 100 languages, though that support is added gradually, is capable in advanced reasoning, coding, and mathematics. It comes in four different sizes. The smallest one is so lightweight that it can work on mobile devices and is fast enough for great interactive applications on device, even when offline. Palm 2 is strongest apparently when fine-tuned on domain knowledge. For example, the Med Palm 2 that is trained on medical knowledge, it is not available yet, and Seg Palm that is specialized on security use cases to help detect, analyze, and explain the behavior of malicious scripts. If you are not happy with Palm 2 for some reason, Google is already training Gemini, the next model that is supposed to be even better. Next, updates to Bard. Bard is now powered by Palm 2. The waitlist is removed and Bard is now available in 180 countries. Not yet in Germany, as of moment I'm recording this video. It supports code generation, debugging, explaining code snippets across more than 20 programming languages. What I found really cool is that it does code citation. You can get the source of that code snippet you are looking at. Coming soon also is export and running the generated code, starting with Python. That will be very interesting to look at. Also, you can send generated text now to Gmail, Docs, Google, spreadsheets. Bard is also gets more visual in responses and in prompts, so you can use images as prompts and also get images from Bard as responses. It will have integration with Adobe Firefly for image generation and has integrations with Google Maps and other tools. Google Lens will be also integrated in the coming month with Bard as well. Generative AI is added into Google Search, offering what is called Search Generative Experience with the AI-powered conversational mode and some extra suggestions, sources, and more. Google Maps now have immersive view for routes. And Google Photo will have Magic Editor, a new AI editing features. Looks cool in the recording, and if you have a Pixel phone, you might get a chance to get early access later this year. In the Google Workspace, a generative AI will help you enhance your slides and give you suggestions for your document content. Google also shared quite an interesting concept, or at least an early version of it, to create a personalized private model that is based on the provided by individual information, for example, through Google Drive. It's called Project Tailwind, and makes a bunch of CSS people unhappy. So with this, you can build your own small models based on the information and expertise that you provide. In the announcement, it was mentioned that it was done by 5 engineers in the past 2 weeks. So let's see how it will go and how far it will go. Outside of the I/O conference, Google also has introduced Product Studio, a new tool that uses generative AI to help businesses create unique and eye-catching product images easily. And if you are interested in AI that is making music, you can finally sign up to try out Music LM, a new experimental AI that can turn your text descriptions into music. Talking about music and sound and Google, we have another model from Google for efficient parallel audio generation. You can listen to samples of dialogue synthesis and see if you could have guessed that it is generated. The performance of the generation is also impressive. Now, moving from Google to Meta. Meta has introduced ImageBind, an AI model that can learn from multiple forms of information simultaneously and without explicit supervision. It can bind information from text, image, video, audio, depth, thermal, and IMU data. ImageBind enables machines to understand and connect objects in photos with their corresponding sounds, 3D shapes, temperature, and motion. Meta claims that it outperforms previous specialist models and opens up possibilities for content recognition, generation, and multi-modal search functions. They also plan to explore new modalities like touch, speed, smell, and brain fMRI signals. Meta has also shared their models and code for massively multilingual speech project. It is impressive to see the results for speech-to-text, text-to-speech for 1,100 plus languages. You can get those models from their GitHub repository. Meta's AI researchers also introduced one more model, which is called LIMA, that stands less is more for alignment, to show that a language model acquires much of its knowledge through pre-training and that rather limited fine-tuning with a few examples is sufficient to teach models to generate high-quality content. Meta makes a conclusion in this research paper that the extensive human feedback training may not be as important as previously thought. Next on my list is IBM, and IBM has introduced Watson XAI, a platform that will provide various tools and resources for foundation models and generative AI. It will include a studio, data store, and governance toolkit to support different aspects of AI development. The studio itself will be built upon Hugging Face's open source libraries and offer thousands of Hugging Face open models and datasets. Moving on to Microsoft, during Build 2023 conference, Microsoft made a number of announcements. First, bringing Bing to ChatGPT. ChatGPT and Bing will be brought together as a default search experience to provide up-to-date answers. So now you can ask real-time answers, and the results include fresh content and citations. The plugins you write for ChatGPT, you'll be able to use for Bing and vice versa. And those plugins also will be working in Edge browser. So while being on some page, you can open Bing chat and ask for information based on what is provided on that page. Second update, Windows Copilot. You get a centralized AI assistance to navigate Windows settings, help you with the work with documents, with your applications, for example, asking for music to be played through Spotify, and use different plugins. Also, Microsoft has introduced Copilot Stack, Not only you can use Copilot as it is, you can make your own for other applications. Microsoft also announced Azure AI Studio to build AI applications and copilots, train the models and do a lot of other stuff. Microsoft has emphasized AI safety and how AI Studio will bring tools for AI safety that can be used by engineering teams on a daily basis. They also announced Microsoft Fabric, and they called it the biggest launch from Microsoft since the launch of SQL Server. Microsoft Fabric is unified data analytics platform for compute and storage, product experience, governance, business models, and the rest. Makes your data to be stored in one format that allows the same copy to be used to train machine learning models, visualize data, and run SQL queries on that data. One format to rule them all sounds suspicious to me, but let's see how they do it. Microsoft has also released Guidance, a language for prompt programming that has a goal to simplify the creation of natural language responses. The idea is that with the help of this new language, developers can now focus on high-level design patterns and easily customize language models using specific instructions. Next on the list is Adobe. Photoshop in beta now includes a feature called Generative Fill. It's generative AI enabling you to generate content from inside Photoshop with a text prompt. It uses Adobe Firefly, which is a set of AI models to generate artistic content. Apple has announced new accessibility features that will be available later this year. These features are for cognitive speech and vision accessibility. Some of the most notable ones are assistive access, which brings apps to their essential features to ease the use by people with cognitive disabilities. With the live feature, you'll be able to type what needs to be said and it will be spoken out loud during phone calls and conversations, benefiting those who are unable to speak. Personal voice feature is designed for those who are at risk of losing their ability to speak, enabling them to create a synthesized voice that sounds like them. Point and Speak will help users with vision disabilities interact with physical objects by reading out loud the text on buttons. This and other accessibility enhancements will help people with various needs and disabilities. In tone with that, Apple is also celebrating Global Accessibility Awareness Day with various initiatives. Next is Anthropic, and moving to the news which brought a lot of attention and discussions. Anthropic has announced that their AI assistant Claude has expanded its context window from 9K to 100K tokens, corresponding to around 75,000 words. That's the first model that got such a big size of the context window. This means that you can now submit hundreds of pages of materials to AI to digest and analyze. In comparison, the maximum for OpenAI GPT-4 is 32K tokens. Next to the notable open source AI news. Fine-tuning large models is very expensive in terms of computational resources. That's why this recent paper, Qlora Efficient Fine-Tuning of Quantist LLMs, is so intriguing. The key conclusion of this paper is that fine-tuning large language models, particularly for researchers or projects with limited computational resources, has a potential to become more accessible. The researchers showed that their method Qlora reduces the average memory requirements for fine-tuning a 65 billion parameter model from over 780 GB of GPU memory to less than 48 GB. So this is 16 times less. This is a significant improvement and makes it possible to fine-tune large models on a single GPU, which was not feasible before. And the authors performed a comprehensive study using QLORA, training over 1,000 models across different datasets, model architectures, and sizes. If you are a software engineer, you might be curious about the next news. Now we have a new open source alternative to GitHub Copilot or ChatGPT to solve programming tasks, such as translating code from one language to another or generating a full implementation from a natural language. BigCode StarCoder is a model trained on 1 trillion tokens sourced from 80 plus programming languages, GitHub issues, Git commits, and Jupyter notebooks. It has 8,192 token context lengths and has an enterprise-friendly license. Hugging Face introduced Transformers Agent. This is a super cool API because it provides access to a bunch of tools and agents that are curated by Hugging Face and is really good with multimodal tasks, generating images, reading text, helping to write code. There is a handy explanation how this works. The instruction written by the user by you is translated into a prompt and using a set of available tools goes to an agent that is a large language model, generates the code that then goes to the Python interpreter to generate the final result. A curated set of tools is comprehensive, but if you lack something, Transformers Agent can also work with your custom tools. All in all, Transformers Agent is like a wrapper allowing quick access through a natural language API to a wide range of tools. If you are into animation tools, you will appreciate the next set of updates. Stability AI has launched Stable Animation SDK, a powerful tool for artists and developers to create animations using advanced stable diffusion models. You can use it in three different ways: text to animation, text input plus initial image input, and input video plus text input. You can use various Stable Diffusion models, including both Stable Diffusion 2.0 and Stable Diffusion XL. Stability AI also introduced Stable Studio, the open source release of their text-to-image consumer application Dream Studio. This is aligned with their goal for open community-driven development rather than a private iteration of a closed source product. Stable Studio is designed to be extensible for external developers. It supports local first development for experimentations and has a new plugin system. Active development is now moved into a public repository and they plan to create bounties for improvements and new features. On a less techy but still quite important topic, the CEO of Stability AI wrote a letter to the United States Senate ahead of the recent hearing about the future of AI and provided a detailed paper emphasizing the importance of open models for transparent, competitive, and resilient digital economy. Mosaic ML has introduced MPT-7B, a transformer model trained from scratch on 1 trillion tokens of text and code. It is an open source model available for commercial use, offering quality which is said to be comparable to Llama 7B. Long blog post going into all details how the model was built and what data was used for training. Another set of models which was released under Apache 2 license are Red Pajama Insight family of models, including Base, Instruction Tuned and Chat models, showing that performant large language models can be built quickly by the open source community. Moving to the next section, which I called Everyone Needs AI. Airtable introduced Airtable AI that will help users to apply AI in their Airtable workflows. Tableau introduced Tableau GPT and Tableau Pool Set with the power of generative AI, adds natural language calculations, suggests appropriate charts and visualizations, auto-generate descriptions of data sources, and automates data analysis, preparation, governance, and does plenty of other things. Slack introduced Slack GPT, so you can integrate AI language model of your choice using partner-built apps, so I guess the choice is limited, from OpenAI's ChatGPT, Anthropic's Claude, and others. Cloudflare introduced Constellation, so developers can upload a supported model to Constellation. They can train them independently or use a pre-trained model. Cloudflare will also maintain a catalog of verified and ready-to-use models. Zoom is partnering with Anthropic, so we should expect more AI features in Zoom. Wendy is working on the drive-thru chatbot that is trained on top of Google's own large language model. To use unique terms, phrases, and acronyms customers have come to use when ordering their burgers, fries, and other items from Wendy's. So maybe very soon you'll be ordering crispy chicken nuggets from artificial intelligence. Next section is cool tools. Starting with DragGun is a new AI tool developed by the Max Planck Institute that allows you to change an image's form, position, expression, or layout using DragGun AI Photo Editor. All of that done realistically with a few clicks and drags. The tool is still in development, but we have a research paper explaining how it works. DragGun first needs to extract features from an image using a convolutional neural network. These features are then used to create a three-dimensional representation of the image. And then a second convolutional neural network is used to modify the 3D model. With Skybox AI, which is a free 360 image generator tool by Blockade Labs, you can now create a skybox from a sketch. So you provide a rough sketch and then add a prompt for details, and Skybox does the rest for you. In the section Interesting Medical Stuff, let's look at this cross-sectional study that took 195 randomly drawn patient questions from a social media forum. And a team of licensed healthcare professionals compared physicians and chatbots' responses to patients' questions asked publicly on a public social media forum. And the conclusion is the chatbot responses were preferred over physician responses and rated significantly higher for both quality and empathy. Why I am not surprised. Another study relevant to a topic shows that ChatGPT outperforms humans in emotional awareness evaluations. ChatGPT can successfully identify and describe emotions from behavioral descriptions in a scenario. It can reflect and abstract emotional states, and the study suggests a possibility that ChatGPT can be part of potential cognitive training to improve ability to identify and describe emotions in clinical settings. Next, moving to the section Important Conversation. The godfather of AI, Geoffrey Hinton, has left Google and now openly talks about AI dangers. His concern is that once AI is smarter than humans, it will figure out how to manipulate people to get what AI wants. Geoffrey Hinton believes that we can stop the progress, but he says we need to be aware that we might have a serious problem that we need to solve. At the same time, the CEO of OpenAI, Sam Altman, testified before Congress and urged lawmakers to regulate artificial intelligence. He proposes that a combination of licensing and testing requirements is applied to development and release of AI models, but only if those are above a threshold of capabilities. He also mentioned that there will be an impact on jobs and there must be partnership between industry and government, but mostly action by government to figure out how to mitigate that impact. Moving to the next section, which I called You're Not Paranoid Yet. And I want to start with this recent paper, which I found to be quite important. It talks about the dangers of training language models that prioritize fluency and coherence over factuality. Once a model makes a mistake, for the sake of being cohesive and consistent, it will adjust other facts to follow the narrative and continue providing wrong information. The researchers of this paper call this phenomenon of hallucination snowballing and demonstrated how frequent it occurs in the most widely currently used models, leading to hallucinations on quite simple facts. A news which, in my opinion, tells more about Twitter rather than AI. On the 22nd of May, a fake generated by AI image showing an explosion near Pentagon appeared in Twitter and was shared by multiple verified Twitter accounts, which caused a brief dip in the stock market. So don't believe everything you see or hear at that matter, because you can also get easily scammed. 60 Minutes hired an ethical hacker to show how easy it is to get scammed. That ethical hacker approached unsuspecting Elizabeth, who is working for 60 Minutes. The hacker found Elizabeth's phone number online on a business website, then used the voice generator to mimic the voice of Elizabeth's colleague, who is quite frequently on TV. Also used a spoofing tool to make a call that looks like coming from Elizabeth's colleague. And using all of that, she asked Elizabeth to share passport number of that other colleague, and Elizabeth gave her that number, since she didn't have reasons to mistrust. Spooky. And this was admittedly not the fullest list of everything which happened in May in AI, but I tried to do my best to find the most interesting and exciting stuff which happened during the past month. Did I miss something important? Let me know in the comment section below.